Hi, I'm Kevin.
And I'm Jenna.
And we are so glad to be a part of your church family here in 2020. This is a Christmas like no one could have ever imagined. So that's why we're bringing Christmas Eve into your homes. We're so excited for you to join us tonight.
We have music, scripture, and even children in tonight's program.
So let's get started. Sit back, relax, grab your favorite type of hot chocolate, and join us for Christmas Eve.
Oh come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel, that mourns in lowly exile here, until the Son of God appear. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel, shall come to thee, O Israel.
At that time, the Roman Emperor Augustus decreed that a census should be taken throughout the Roman Empire. This was the first census taken when Quirinius was governor of Syria. All returned to their own ancestral towns to be registered for this census. And because Joseph was a descendant of King David, he had to go to Bethlehem in Judea, David's ancient home. He traveled there from the village of Nazareth in Galilee. He took with him Mary, his fiancée, who was now obviously pregnant. And while they were there, the time came for her baby to be born. She gave birth to her first child, a son. She wrapped him snugly in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no lodging available. That night there were shepherds staying in the fields nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. Suddenly an angel of the Lord appeared among them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. They were terrified. But the angel reassured them. "Don't be afraid," he said. "I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David. And you will recognize him by this sign. You will find a baby wrapped snugly in strips of cloth, lying in a manger." Suddenly the angel was joined by a vast host of others, the armies of heaven, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in highest heaven, and peace on earth to those with whom God is pleased." When the angels returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that the Lord has told us about." They hurried to the village and found Mary and Joseph, and there was the baby lying in. After seeing him, the shepherds told of everyone what had happened and what the angel had told them about this child. All who heard their story were astonished, but Mary kept all these things in her heart and thought about them often. The shepherds returned to their flocks, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen. It was just as the angel.
Good evening, it's Christmas Eve 2020. Tonight we celebrate the coming of Jesus. We've spent 4 weeks talking about the coming of Christ. Pastor Matthew shared the Christmas story. We've talked about hope, we've talked about peace, we've talked about joy. But tonight I want to talk about love. And rather than focusing on Luke 2 that Pastor Matthew read, I first want us to look in John 1. John 1 tells us that Jesus existed from the very beginning. In the beginning was the Word. The Word already existed. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. He existed in the beginning with God. See, God created everything through him, and nothing was created except through him. The Word, Jesus, gave life to everything that was created, and he was the light that brought life into the darkness. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness can never extinguish it. Jesus is the light that the world needs. He's the fulfillment of hope. He's the bringer of peace, the giver of joy. And he's love itself. As you watch this, whether you're watching by yourself as an individual or with your family, I want you to take just a moment to look at everything that you have. But Kevin, you don't know me. 2020 was a horrific year. I've lost a lot. I'm here to tell you something. If you know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you have all that you need. But I'm here to remind you today that you have something far more valuable than all of those things. As a believer, you have something far greater than anyone else can possess. If you believe that Jesus came to bring you salvation, if you believe he is your Lord and Savior, then you possess life itself. And better yet, you are now a reflection of who he is to the entire world. The night Jesus was born, light shone into the darkness, and it still shines in the darkness today. Tonight with me, proclaim boldly, let earth receive her King. During Christmas here in 2020, I am challenging you to be the reflection of Jesus Christ. I'm challenging you to be the light that steps into the darkness. I'm challenging you to reach out to both loved ones and ones you may not even know, to share his hope, his peace, his joy, and his love. The true gift of Christmas is that the light that we bear and the love that we hold isn't just for us, it's for the entire world to share. Remember the song, "This Little Light of Mine"? Please, let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. 1 John 4:9 through 12 says this: God showed how much he loved us by sending his one and only Son into the world so that we might have eternal life. This is real love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as a sacrifice to take away our sins. Dear friends, since God loved us that much, we surely ought to love each other. No one has ever seen God, but if we love each other, God lives in us. And his love is brought to full expression in us, in you. Carry the love and light of Jesus Christ into the world, a world that is full of his beloved. I beg of you, if you know Jesus, please don't hog his love for yourself, but seek to share it with someone else, anyone else. As great as his love is, we as Christians and as believers can't become content sitting on our one-way ticket to heaven. We need to take the gift he's given us and allow it to drive us deep from within. We need to be aware of this, watching and seeking what the Holy Spirit desires to do with us and through us as we seek to walk in obedience to Jesus Christ. So this Christmas season, during tonight, this Christmas Eve service, I'm going to ask you to pray that you would be sensitive to the voice of the Holy Spirit. I'm going to ask you to seek to understand others. Even when you potentially get together with family and that one person that drives you crazy starts in and you're about ready to just smack them. Don't smack, but listen. Don't hear, but listen. Seek to understand. And do it with the loving attitude of Jesus Christ. Families, I ask that tonight you rejoice with me. Let earth receive her King. Jesus has come on Christmas, but he will be coming again and returning soon. How great of a promise is that? Know fully that you are the beloved of God and embrace the gift of Jesus Christ coming this Christmas season. Go into a world that is longing for hope, peace, joy, and has never felt true love. The only unconditional love there is, the love that comes from Jesus Christ. Shine your light among them, among neighbors, among strangers, that they may know and realize that they too are God's beloved and that his gift is free for them just as it was for you. And last but not least, join me in prayer as we continue to usher in his kingdom. Your will be done, not mine. Your kingdom come, not mine. Let it be here on earth as it is in heaven. Merry Christmas.
Christmas when all through the town, every inn was so crowded, no room could be found. Tired Mary and Joseph went door to door, at last found a place on a small stable floor. Thank goodness, said Mary, who tiptoed inside. The mice saw the donkey and scurried to hide. The rest of the creatures all cuddled up tight in hopes that they might have a calm, peaceful night. The pigeons were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of breadcrumbs danced round in their heads. The cows closed their eyes and the oxen laid down. The doves cooed so gently, the lambs made no sound. The moon through the trees was just starting to glow with a glimmer of light on the stable below, when quite by surprise came a newborn babe's cry that woke all the animals sleeping nearby. Up jumped the cows and the oxen and sheep. Up popped the pigeons, aroused from their sleep. They all came to gaze at the small baby boy as his mama and papa hugged him with joy. Now donkeys, now cows, now pigeons and sheep, now oxen and mice in the manger did peep. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples so sweet, as they nuzzled his fingers and cute little feet. And out in the fields, taking care of their sheep, some shepherds were just getting ready to sleep, when all of a sudden they had such a fright as a whole choir of angels lit up the night. But the song of the angels, the words that they said, soon let the men know they had nothing to dread. Dear shepherds, it's wonderful news that we bring. A Savior is born. He is Jesus the King. They ran to the stable and peeked through the door and saw something never imagined before. 4. There, in a manger, a baby boy lay. No blankets, no pillow, his bed made of hay. And to that small stable came 3 splendid kings, with gifts for the baby, all beautiful things. They jumped from their camels and knelt at his feet, with frankincense, gold, and myrrh that smelled sweet. The stable was filled with a wonderful light, as stars above Bethlehem twinkled so bright, and high in the heavens God whispered, "My son, you'll bring hope to the world and love everyone." Then back to their slumbers the animals curled, amazed at this babe who had entered their world. As Mary and Joseph got ready for bed, they snuggled their baby and kissed his sweet head. As Mary laid Jesus asleep in the hay, she thought about all that had happened that day. The mice heard her whisper as she tucked him in tight. Merry Christmas, my son, and to all a good night.
That's all we have planned for tonight. We hope you have a wonderful Christmas Eve time with your family, whether they're with you or not. And we're so glad that you were able to join us.
From our family to yours, we wish you the merriest Christmas.